Okay, I hope this is going to turn out to be a good video. This is basically the breakdown of a 93 4L60E out of a K1500 truck, four-wheel drive. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here, and to start out with, this is your low reverse piston, return spring, your bearing, and there's also a snap ring that holds that spring down inside the casing. And then basically we're going to come up here and do this. This is your parking cog ring gear, the bearing. This is your low reverse planetary, and then you basically have your low reverse clutch pack. And your low reverse clutch pack pressure plate with the snap ring that holds that in place. And then let me get a close-up of this as much as I can. This is your basically your one-way roller clutch. This is your low reverse sprag, and this is a snap ring that holds the low reverse sprag, the low reverse sprag inside the pressure plate, which basically goes in there. And then you have your race that goes inside the one-way roller clutch. And we're going to come over here, and what you have here is you have your sun gear reaction gear, your reverse sun gear shell, and you have a plastic washer that goes on the back of that sun gear shell. And you come here, then we have a thrush washer. It's a four-tab thrush washer that goes on the inside of that sun gear shell. And then you have what we call a input carrier ring gear, which goes down inside that sun gear shell. And then once that's put in there, you have a bearing that goes on the back of this input planetary. And then once all that put together, you have a little snap ring that holds all that into place on the output shaft. Okay, now we're going to go over here, and now we have what we call the forward sprag. Okay, basically, the top gear inside that goes in, is going to actually go inside this here. Now, well, what I'll do is I'll turn it over, and you can look at the underside of it. I'm trying to hold this as steady as I can, so bear with me. Okay, now we're going to go down here to the clutch packs, but I'm going to start out how they go into the input shell. Okay, this here is your overrun clutch. When you're coasting and stuff like that, basically that's what that's for. Then we go up here to the forward clutch pack. Okay, this is like your second gear clutch pack. Okay, and now you go over here to the 3-4 clutch pack. Now this is the one that normally has a lot of issues in these transmissions. They like to burn out because of lack of fluid or being used to tow with or plow with. Okay, now we're going to come over here to the last clutch pack in the transmission. This is your high reverse clutch pack. And basically, where that goes, it's going to go in here. You have your high reverse shell drum, and you have your high reverse piston, and you have your high reverse return spring, and then you have your C-clip, which holds all that into the drum, and then you actually start out with this wave spring here, and then you have steel, friction, steel, frictions, and you have your pressure plate here, and you have your snap ring that holds all that into the drum. Now with that being said, this normally doesn't burn out. This is one of the things that normally doesn't get a lot of use, other than being in second gear and fourth gear. The band will lock up on that drum and stop that drum, and the band will also lock up on the nope, that's the only band in there, so that band's going to lock up. Okay. Anyways, this gives you a basic rundown of what's inside the 4L60E. I do not have all the components up here to show you, but to give you a basic idea, this is a lot of the rotating assembly, the drums and everything like that. I'm going to add another video onto this, which will actually show you the input drum, everything that comes out of it, and a lot more stuff to go along with this. We're also going to cover the pump assembly and what's all in the pump assembly. But again, this is from a 93 4L60E. It's the heavy-duty K model case. And this transmission, the forward clutch pack burnt up, the 3/4 clutch pack burnt up. The high reverse started getting a little warm, but I just thought I'd show you basically what happens here. I will also show you the clutch plates. This is the 3/4. Okay, this is basically what happens when they start burning up. You can see the discoloration, you can see the burn rings around the steels and everything. Now the actual friction plate itself has coned. What happens is it gets so hot that it cones. If you can see this, I'll try to show you the best I can, but it's actually coned up from so much heat created. Then you get to your overrun clutch plates, and like I say, your forward clutch plates, and they were getting hot too. So I hope this helps you out. We'll add another video on as soon as we can. Again, I'm Paul with P&J Transmission and Engine Rebuilding. Our website is pandjtrans.com. Please give us a call, 269-492-8972. Thank you, and have a wonderful day.